Cloud. All right. Welcome everyone to NWABA's circuit workout today. This is Megan from Vancouver, Washington, at our office. And so today we have our circuit workout. We'll start with a warm-up, some dynamic warm-ups. We'll be moving around, and then we'll move into four different circuits. With each circuit, we have four exercises per circuit, and we'll do an upper body, lower body, back, core, and then cardio. So four exercises to hit those four areas of our body. With those four exercises, we'll do them for 30 seconds each, taking a 10-second transition time to get to the next exercise, and then we'll do three cycles of 30 seconds each. Okay, so and then before each circuit starts, I will explain all the exercises and we'll go from there if people have questions. We'll end the workout with a cool down. All right. With that, let's start our warm up. So let's just walk in place in our space that we have. I'm currently using a yoga mat for my space that I'm orienting to. I have a white background and a white floor with high contrast black clothing on for those with low vision. So we're walking in place, starting to move around. And next, we will get into doing some arm circles. So I'll bring my feet to a still spot, extend my arms out to the sides laterally, so my wrists are even with my shoulders, and I'll go top, forward on the top, backwards on the bottom of my circles, drawing circles on the walls to each side of me. Smaller first, and we'll work up to bigger ones. Excellent. And as you're getting bigger and bigger, when you're at the biggest size that you're going to make, we'll reverse directions and go forward on the bottom and backwards on the top of our circles, loosening up our shoulders, getting some movement in our upper arms, waking up our upper body. Here we go. All right, I'm down to little circles. And next, we're going to move down our body. Let's do some windmill toe touches. So I'm going to take a wider stance, wider than shoulders width apart. Keeping my arms out to the sides, like I had them for the my arm circles, and it's flex at my waist, bringing my left fingertips down to my right toes, and then standing back upright again, bringing my right fingertips down to my left toes, and then back up again. And let's do a few of these to loosen up our torso, our back, starting to engage our core as we will in our exercises today, and then also loosening up our upper leg muscles, our quads in the front, and our glutes and hamstrings in the back of our upper legs. I'm gonna do three more on each side, three more windmill toe touches on each side. Two, last one. And with that, I'm going to start moving my feet. Let's do some high knees in the front. So as you take a step, we'll bring our knee up forward, so that your knee is about even with your hip. And we'll march in place to high knees. And as you're bringing your left foot off the ground, your right arm is swinging forward with a 90-degree bend in your elbow, as if you were taking a popsicle, not a popsicle, how about a lollipop, from your pocket to your mouth. And then opposition with, as you bring your right foot off the ground, we're swinging our left arm forward. Awesome. And feel free to pick up the pace if you're ready to pick it up a little bit. All right. And we'll turn our high knees into glute kicks by bringing our heel back to our glute. So, focusing on that motion of bringing our heel back to our glute. This is stretching our quads in the front of our leg more so. Again, if you want to jog in place with glute kicks, feel free to do so. As we get into our circuits, I'll put on some music so we can exercise to the beat. We'll get there. A few more glute kicks. I'm just kind of walking back and forth on my yoga mat as I'm kicking my butt or my glutes with my heel. And I'm going to bring my feet to a still stand in the middle. And last one, last warm up, we're going to do our calf raises. So, with calf raises, we'll bring the weight to the balls of our feet, lifting our heels up off the mat, and then returning them to the mat. We're waking up our ankle muscles and our calves, the back muscle of our lower legs. If you'd like to, as your heel comes down, bring your toes up off the mat, getting a little flexion and extension in our calf muscles, working our ankle muscles that are very important for our balance. Doing a few more. I'm gonna do a handful more. Got squeaky shoes on today. And last one. All right. And with that brings us th to the end of our warm-up exercises. We'll get into our first circuit. So, for our first circuit, our upper body exercise will be elbow squeezes. So, with this one, if you have your elbows in towards your rib cage and your arms are extended, your elbows could be bent at a 90-degree bend or just relax down. And yep, we're going to squeeze our shoulder blades together, bringing our elbows back as if they were to touch each other behind our back, which isn't really physically possible. But we'll go from a relaxed pose to squeezing our shoulder blades and bringing our elbows together behind our body. So that squeezing motion of elbow squeezes. Okay. Yep, that looks great. Excellent. And then for our lower body exercise for the first circuit, we're going to do lateral leg lifts. So standing central on my mat, I'm going to lift my left leg out to the laterally out to the side at a height that is comfortable, and then back towards center, and then back out. As we do our circuits, we'll do three circuits, three rounds of each exercise. And I'll give you the 15-second mark halfway through so we can switch to the other side. So we'll do lateral leg lifts on the left side for 15 seconds and then on the right side for 15 seconds. The next one will be starting in tabletop position on the mat. It will be twisting mountain climbers. So from the mountain, I'm sorry, the tabletop position, we're going to go onto our feet into a plank position. And then we'll bring our left knee towards our right elbow underneath our body, and then return it to the mat. And then we'll take our right knee and bring it towards our left elbow, and then return it to the mat. So we have a little twisting motion in our core as we're bringing one knee forward towards our opposite elbow. In this one, you can definitely pick up the pace if you want to up your game a little bit and want that extra challenge. The fourth exercise in our first circuit are side jacks or jumping jacks. So again, starting from standing position, centered on my mat. For side jacks, I'll step out my right foot, and as I do, I'll bring my right hand above my head, and then I'll step back in, bringing my right arm down, and then left side, stepping laterally to the left. As I do, I'm bringing my left hand up above my head, and then back towards center, bringing my arm down. So that's a side jack. And then a full jumping jack is jumping your feet out at the same time. And as you jump your feet out, bringing your hands up above your head, tapping your toes above, I'm sorry, tapping your fingertips above your head, and then jumping your feet back together, bringing your arms back down along your sides. With that, are there any questions for the exercises in the first circuit? It's a lot of information. Okay, so we will start with elbow squeezes. And I'm starting my timer. It will give you a 3-second countdown to begin. And I'll start the music. Here we go. Elbow squeezes in three, two, one, go.
Exercise.
All right, so you have 30 seconds doing elbow squeezes. Let me know if the music is too loud and you can't hear my voice over it.
Can't hear music.
I don't hear any. There's no music.
No music. You know what? I didn't share my audio. Thank you. Keep going strong. Getting ready to switch to. So we're resting, switching to standing lateral leg lifts next. In three, two, one, go. Standing lateral leg lifts. Let me get the music shared here. All right, now you should be able to hear the music, yeah? In 15 seconds, we'll switch to the other side. So we're working on balance and also lower body. And resting in 3, 2, 1, rest. Moving to twisting cross body mountain climbers next. In 3, 2, 1, go. We're in that plank position, bringing one knee forward to the opposite elbow underneath our body. And with this, feel free to pick up the pace, go as fast as you can. We're making sure to engage our core to support our structure and our torso. Engaging our core by sucking our belly button back to our spine. 3, 2, 1, resting. And we'll get up on our feet for our jumping jacks or side jacks. Last one of our first round. And go. Side jacks, jumping jacks. Again, pick a pace that's right for you. Feel free to take the challenge, amp it up today for a circuit workout. Keep going strong, you're doing great. More than halfway there. Three, two, one, resting. Moving into our elbow squeezes next. In 3, 2, 1, elbow squeezes. So again, we're squeezing our shoulder blades together, bringing our elbows as if they were to touch behind our body. Really working our chest and pecs, our back muscles and of our upper back. And doing great. Resting in 3, 2, 1, resting. Moving into standing leg lifts next, lateral leg lifts next. 3, 2, 1, and go. Lateral leg lifts. 15 seconds on one side and we'll switch. Feel free to hold onto a stationary object if you choose. Or maybe just tap a finger down when you need that extra balance. And switch sides. Can you hear the music now?
Yes. Oh yeah.
Okay. Is it too loud?
Nope.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, resting. Getting ready for our twisting crossbody mountain climbers next. In 3, 2, 1, go. With our circuits today, getting up and down is part of our workout, as we'll be going from standing position to floor positions with our twisting mountain climber here, bringing one knee at a time towards the opposite elbow underneath our body. Keep going, doing well. 3, 2, 1, resting. Whew. Moving into our side jacks, jumping jacks next. Already warming up in here, gotta say. And go. Jumping jacks, side jacks. Awesome. Doing great, everyone. Halfway there, keep going strong. See if you can get 5 more in there, 10 more in there. Moving our arms up above our heads, stepping laterally out to the side or jumping our feet out. And resting, moving into our third sequence. Moving into elbow squeezes next. 3, 2, 1, go. Squeezing our elbows together behind our back. Strengthening our upper back, shoulders, pecs. A little disco action today. 70s music with a little upbeat. 3, 2, 1, resting. Moving to standing lateral legs, leg lifts next. In 3, 2, 1, go. Leg lifts on one side for 15 seconds. Remembering to breathe as we're working on our balance with this one too. Oh, let's switch sides. And keep going strong. 3, 2, 1, resting. Moving into our mountain climbers next. 3, 2, 1, go. Mountain climbers, starting from that plank position, bringing one knee at a time, across our body, engaging our core, keeping our back safe, remembering to breathe. Keep holding strong, you're doing great. Interesting. Whew. Back up on our feet for jumping jacks, side jacks. Breaking a sweat here. And go. Side jacks, jumping jacks. Nice. Last one in this circuit. Finish it strong. How many can you get in this round of exercises? 10 more seconds to go. Woo-hoo. 3, 2, 1, complete. I'm gonna pause and reset my timer. Pause the music for a moment. Now's a good time to get a drink of water to stay hydrated. There we go. Awesome job. One circuit down. Gonna grab a drink and then I'll explain circuit number two. All right. Circuit number two. Our upper body exercise will be overhead tricep extensions. So we'll start with our hands reaching up towards the sky. And you can do this with weights or without weights. And then we'll bend at our elbows, bringing our hands back behind our head to go down towards our back, and then we'll extend our arms back up again. So again, bending our elbows, so our hands are coming back down towards our back, and then extending them upward towards the sky. If you have a weight, feel free to use a weight or weights for this one. Okay. Again, extending our arms up, and then bending at our elbows to bring our hands back behind our head for overhead tricep extensions. Lower body exercise will be clock lunges. So with this, Terry, that looks great. Yep. With clock lunges, I'm gonna step forward with my left foot towards 12 o'clock. I step forward, I'm gonna lunge down, bringing my back knee down towards the ground, not touching. And also being mindful that my front knee is staying over my ankle, not going in front of my toes. As I lunge down, I'll come back up, step my left foot towards 9 o'clock, do a side lunge, and come back up to center. And then I'll step my left foot back to 6 o'clock, lunging down, bringing my left knee down towards the ground. Again, being mindful that my front knee, my right knee is staying over my foot, not going in front of my toes. And as I come up, bringing my foot back to center, bringing my right foot back to 6 o'clock, doing a backwards lunge, lunging down, bringing that foot back to center, right foot to 3 o'clock, side lunge, and then back up to center, and then left foot to 12 o'clock, lunging forward from there. That is our that's our clock lunges. So we're going around the clock, stepping in one direction towards one quadrant of the clock. The next one for our back and core muscles is bird dog. So again, starting in tabletop position on the floor. With bird dog, I'm going to extend from tabletop position, extend my left arm forward so that my wrist is even with my shoulder, extending my right leg back behind my body so that my ankle is even with my knee and my hips. And I have a straight line from my fingertips of my left hand through the toes of my right leg. Extend out, bringing my elbow and knee together underneath my body, extending out again, and then returning that hand and knee to the mat. And then I'll do the same thing on the other side, extending my right arm forward, left leg backwards, bringing my right elbow and left knee towards each other underneath my body, extending out again, and then bringing that right hand and left knee back to the mat. Okay, that's bird dog. So out, in, out, back to the mat, and then switch sides. And then for our cardio exercise, we're gonna do a side shuffle. So back up in standing position, starting at the left side of my mat. I'm gonna shuffle my feet to the right. And then when I get to the end of my space on the right, I'm gonna shuffle back to the left. So sidestepping, shuffling our feet. This one, you can definitely pick up the pace for that greater challenge. Side shuffling left, side shuffling right. Okay, four exercises in circuit two. Any questions? All right, so we're ready to hit it. Let me make sure my timer is reset. All right. Resetting.
Yeah, reset.
And so we'll start with our overhead tricep extensions in 3, 2, 1, go. All right, overhead tricep extensions. Again, you can up the challenge by using weights if you choose. Having our hands up towards the sky, bending at our elbows, bringing our hands back down behind our head. Really engaging that muscle in the back part of our upper arm. Nice. And we'll rest in 3, 2, 1, resting. Moving into our clock lunges next. In 3, 2, 1, go. Left to 12, lunging. Left to center, left to 9 o'clock. Side lunging, left to center, left behind us to 6 o'clock, lunging, up, right to 6 o'clock, lunging, right to 3 o'clock, lunging, back to center, right to 12 o'clock, lunging, and return. Ooh, can we get a couple more in? And resting, maybe next round. All right, moving into bird dog next. So down on the mat. And go. Bird dog, extending left arm forward, right leg back. Center, extending out again, returning to the mat. Extending left, right arm, left leg out. And back to the mat. Remembering to breathe as we're working our core. And resting, back on our feet for a side shuffle next for cardio. And 3, 2, 1, side shuffle. Here we go. Fast feet, moving to the left, moving to the right. Awesome. See if we can get a couple more rounds in here. Going left and right. Side shuffle. And resting in 3, 2, 1, resting. Back to the top with our overhead tricep extensions next. In 3, 2, 1, go. Up to the sky with our hands. And then bringing our hands back behind our head. Really working that upper arm muscle, the backs of our arms. engaging that muscle. Grabbing some weights, up in the game. Hold strong, get a couple more in. 3, 2, 1, resting. Awesome job. Moving back to our clock lunges next. And go. I'll let you call your clock as we go to 12 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 6 o'clock twice, 3 o'clock, back to 12. As we're doing our lunges, you want to make sure your upper body is in good position with shoulders tall, head tall, strong upper body. So we're working our legs and resting. Excellent. Moving back down to the mat for bird dog next. 3, 2, 1, lift off. Bird dog, here we go. Working our core, making sure we're engaging our core by sucking our belly button back to our spine. Keeping a good position with our back. Don't want to have a sway in our back, but a nice strong flat back. Working our balance with this one a little bit too. Keep going strong, you're doing great. And resting. Back to our feet for our side shuffle next. In 3, 2, 1, shuffle. Time to shuffle. Shuffle the beat. This is a fast beat. But we got this. Nice job, everyone. Shuffling side to side, laterally. Awesome. 3, 2, 1, resting. Moving to a third round of tricep extensions next. 3, 2, 1, go. Tricep extensions. Pick up those weights or not. Extending our hands up to the sky and then back behind our back. Making sure our chin and our nose is pointing forward, not looking down. Again, tall and proud, head high. Nice job, everyone. Doing great. Keep working those triceps so we can feel it tomorrow, building new muscles. 3, 2, 1, resting. Moving into clock lunges next. 3, 2, 1, clock lunges. Here we go. Around the clock we go. Lunging down, getting a nice workout in our quads. Going down, glutes and hams coming back up again. Squeeze those glutes to burst you up to standing position. 3, 2, 1, awesome job. Moving into bird dog next, down on the mat, down on the floor. 3, 2, 1, time for our bird dogs. Nice strong back and core to support our body. Doing awesome. Whew. Get a couple more in here. We got this. Get one more in. And resting. Great. Back on our feet for our side shuffles. And go. Fast feed, side shuffling. Make this one the best. Last one in our second circuit here. Fast feet. Keeping our heart and lungs healthy with this cardio exercise. Whew. Couple more times, here we go. And that is time. Awesome job. Circuit 2 complete. We may pause the music and I'm gonna grab a drink of water. Feel free to do the same. Whew. All right. How's everyone doing?
Good.
Good.
All right. What was that?
All I know is I'm going to be sore tomorrow.
Yes, that's what we strive for, building new muscles. As long as we're stretching our muscles, not straining them, right?
Mm-hmm.
Great.
Thank you, May.
Excellent. All right, well, we'll move into our third circuit. For the upper body exercise, we're going to do hammer curls. So with that, we'll extend our arms from a standing position. I have my arms resting down alongside my body, and I'm going to keep my elbows in towards my ribs and bring my fists up towards my shoulders, so flexing at my elbows. And you can do both arms at the same time. This is a great one if you want to use weights. You can use weights for. So again, hammer curls are going from arms being in a straight position by your sides, hinging at your elbows, bringing your fists up towards your shoulders. Yep, looks great. Yeah. And then, any questions with hammer curls? Moving to glute bridges next. So this one will start on our back on the floor.
Excuse me.
Yeah, go ahead.
I have a question.
Yeah.
So your arms are supposed to, with the curls, your arms are supposed to be straight or... Because when I have my arms by my side and mm-hmm. have my fists balled up, it goes to my chest. So do I have to, like, turn my fists, like, if I were to turn my palms, like if someone were to hand me a snack or something?
Yeah, good question. So when I, in my starting position, my arms are alongside my body with my palms facing forward. And then as I flex at my elbows, as I bring my forearms up, my palms of my hands stay out. And if you want to keep an open hand, then you can just tap your shoulders as you bring your hands up towards your shoulders and then bringing them back down again.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Is that helpful?
Yes.
Okay, great. Thanks for asking. All right, so glute bridges. We'll go down on our back on the ground. So I'm laying on the mat. My knees are pointed up towards the sky with my feet flat on the ground. And my hands are resting, palms down on the mat. And I'm going to raise my hips off the mat so that as my hips are raising up towards the sky, I have from my knees down to my hips, through my shoulders, this kind of like a straight line. And then I'll relax and let my hips fall back down to the mat. As we're doing our glute bridges, we're engaging our core. And also, this is definitely a glute exercise. You should feel this in the backs of your upper legs. So we're just lifting our hips up towards the sky for our glute bridges. Next, we have our heel beats. So with this one, we're gonna flip to our belly down on the mat. So now I'm laying on my stomach, and you can just relax your head, rest your head on your hands down on the mat. I'm going to then lift my knees and feet off the mat. So from my hips through to the top of my body is on the mat. With my feet off and my knees off the mat, I'm going to bring my heels together, and then I'm going to take them apart and then back together again. So we're just moving our feet from being touching in the center to out, maybe about a foot or two, and then back together again. So with this one, we're engaging our core. As we suck our belly button back to our spine, we're also using our lower back muscles to support our body as our feet and knees are off the mat and have that motion laterally going out and back in again with our heels. Any questions with that one? All right. Moving into our cardio. So we'll get back up into standing position. And we'll do high knees with a core twist for this one. So with high knees, like we did in our warm-up, we'll bring, as we bring our left knee up forward, so our left knee is even with our hip, my right elbow, I'm going to bring towards my left knee in front of my body. So left knee up, right elbow towards my left knee, and then opposite. As I bring my right knee up, even with my hip, my left elbow will come towards my right knee. And then we'll just go back and forth with high knees with a core twist. Okay. Yep, awesome. That looks great. So we're twisting our body and bringing our knees up in front of us. As we do this, we want to maintain that strong upper body position with our shoulders back and head up tall as we twist our core. Okay. Awesome. I think that is all four of them. Any questions with any of the four? All right. We will start with our hammer curls in 3, 2, 1, go. Hammer curls. So again, with the extra challenge, you could add weights if you choose. We're bringing our hands from resting along by our hips up towards our shoulders, keeping our elbows in towards our ribs, and curling that hammer up towards our shoulders. Nice. Engaging our biceps. 3, 2, 1, resting. Moving to our glute bridges next, which is on the floor. Laying flat on our back. And go. So feet are planted on the mat, up close to our butts. And then knees pointed up towards the ceiling, hands resting on the floor next to us as we lift our hips up towards the sky. And then back down again. You can do bursts. See how many you can get in one 30-second period. Bringing our hips up towards the sky with our glute kicks. I'm sorry, not glute kicks. Glute bridges. And we're resting. Flipping our pancake to our belly for heel beats next. And go. So from laying flat on our stomach position, going to lift, rest my head on my hands in front of me, and then raise my knees and ankles up off the floor, bringing my legs out to the sides and back in towards the center again. For our heel beaters. Making sure we're engaging our core to keep our back safe and work those lower back muscles and core muscles. Resting. Moving to standing position for the cardio exercise of high knee, core twist, and go. High knees with a core twist. Remembering to breathe, working our heart and lungs. Here we go. If you want the extra challenge, you can pick up the pace to a jogging pace. Get a few more in, you got this. And resting. Moving back to our hammer curls next. Wait, did I do that right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And go.
Megan, a resistance band works really well with these two.
What does?
A resistance band.
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. That would work well.
Yes. I'm feeling it even more than I would with my weight because I'm getting it both ways.
In resting? Nice. Nice. All right. Moving to our glute bridges next. And go. Yeah, resistance bands work well. Stand on them and then you can pull it up. Nice. So with our glute bridges here, lifting your hips up towards the sky from a laying on our back position. Bursts of glute bridges. Three, two, one, resting. Awesome job. We'll go onto our belly for heel beats next. 3, 2, 1, going. Heel beats, here we go. How many heel beats can you get in 30 seconds? Let's do this. Keep going strong, you're doing great. And resting. Resting those glutes. And back up for our high knee core twists. And go. High knee core twists. Three, two, one, resting. I believe this is the last round of our hammer curls coming up. And go. Hammer curls. Curling those weighty hammers up or using that resistance band. Great idea. Bringing that resistance band up towards your shoulder and back down again. All right, we got about 5 more seconds. Get a few more in and resting. Awesome. Back to our glute bridges next. Lying on the ground. And go. Glute bridges. Maybe glute bridges to the beat. Remembering to engage our core, keeping our back safe. Doing awesome. And resting. Moving to our stomachs for our heel beats. 3, 2, 1, go. Heel beats. Clicking our heels together. Going to the center. Bringing our legs out to the sides. A little more than shoulders width apart. Keep going strong, you're doing great. Heel burn. And resting. Back up to our feet for our last round of high knee core twists. In 3, 2, 1, go. Awesome job. Four, three, two, one, complete. Awesome job. Pausing timer, resetting it, pausing the music. Whew, good one. All right, I'm gonna grab a drink and then we'll go into our fourth circuit. All right, fourth circuit is for upper body, we're gonna do Supermans, which is lying flat on our belly. And similar to the heel beats, we'll continue doing the heel beat by lifting our knees and feet off the mat. And also with our arms, we're gonna extend them out forward in front of us. And we'll engage our arm muscles by lifting our arms off the mat. And if you want the added challenge, you can also lift your legs off the mat too. So lift our hands and feet off the mat, letting them hover above the ground about 3 to 6 inches, and then rest, bring them back down to the ground, and then engage. And we'll just do pulses of Supermans for upper body. The next one will be lying lateral scissor switches. So with that, we'll roll onto our back and putting my hands along my sides to support my body. I'm going to lift my feet off the mat and scissor my feet out and back in. And if you want to cross them, feel free to do so. So we're engaging our core and lifting our legs up off the mat to bring our feet out and back in again. From laying on our back this time, those are lateral scissor, laying lateral scissor switches. And then for our upper body, we're going to do good mornings. So from standing position, we will reach our hands up towards the sky, bringing our hands down towards our feet, hinging at our waist and our hips, and then back up again. And bringing our hands down towards the ground and then back up towards the sky. Engaging our core as we're doing good mornings. We're also engaging our legs as we go down. And then back up, we're squeezing our glutes to stand back up again. Okay? So those are good mornings. And then the last one we're going to do is glute kicks, which we did in our warm-up. So simply bringing our feet up towards our glutes in a running, walking, sprinting pace, whichever you choose. So those are our last four for the fourth circuit. Any questions? All right, so we will start with our Supermans in three. Whoops, just kidding. Reset. All right, now starting our Supermans in three, two, one, go. Supermans down on the floor, bringing our hands off the ground, letting them hover, and then relaxing them back into the ground. Extra challenge, you can lift your legs off the ground too. Pulsing, engaging, and then relaxing. Three, two, one, resting. Getting into our lateral scissor switches position, so on from our backs. Three, two, one, go. So from laying on our backs, lift our feet off the mat and scissor them. This is definitely a core exercise as well, making sure that we're keeping our back safe by engaging our core and ensuring that our lower back is resting on the mat. If you need an adaptation, feel free to bring a little bend in your knees and scissor your feet closer to your body. Resting. 30 seconds goes fast. Next, we'll be on our feet for good mornings. And go. Reaching up to the sky, hinging at our waist. Bending down to our toes and back up again. Engaging our glutes and our quads as we're going from standing position to that forward fold position. Awesome job. All right, and resting. Moving to glute kicks next. In three, two, one, glute kicks. So we're bringing our heels back to our glutes, kicking our butt. Moving our arms forward in opposition with that foot that's off the ground. And resting in three, two, one, resting. Dun, dun, dun. Where are we? We are back to Supermans. And go. So from laying on our stomach, lifting our arms up off the ground, hovering, and then relaxing. Keep going strong, you're doing great. Nope, resting. back to laying on our back for our scissor legs. 3, 2, 1, and go. Scissoring our legs. If you want the full challenge, you can extend your legs in a straighter position. If you need a modification to keep your back safe, you can have a slight bend in your knees. Bringing your feet out laterally to the side and then back in, crossing. Remembering to breathe as we are engaging our core. And resting back on our feet for our good mornings. And go. Good morning. Hands to the sky. And then down to our feet. Again, engaging those upper leg muscles in front and in back. Three, two, one, resting. And lastly, our glute kicks. And this is going to be the last one because we're 5 minutes till the top of the hour. And go, glute kicks. Make this one the best. We're only gonna do 2 rounds of this final circuit as I wanna allow time for cool down. Time flies when you're having fun.
Yes.
Nice. Glute kicks, here we are. Nice tall upper back and head. And complete. Awesome job, everyone. I'm gonna pause the music for cool down. Cool is right. Awesome job. I'm gonna grab a drink and then we'll do a few cool down exercises. All right, so for our cool down, let's just start with our legs as we were doing some glute kicks. I'm gonna hold on to something stationary and kick my right foot up into my right hand. I'm gonna stretch out my quad, the upper muscle in the front of my right leg by balancing on my left leg and holding on to my right foot. We'll hold there for just a couple of breaths. Stretching out our quad. And let's release that. And what we do on one side, we'll do on the other side. So we'll kick our left foot up into our left hand. If you need to hold on to something stationary, feel free to do so. Stretching out our left quad, holding for just a couple of breaths. Slowing down our heart rhythm a little bit, heart rate. And let's release that. And let's do a forward fold to stretch out our hamstrings. So from standing position, feet shoulders width apart, I'm just gonna fold forward and hold down, bringing my hands towards the mat. If you'd like to cross your hands in front of you to allow more of a stretch in your hamstrings, in your glutes, feel free to do that and relax your neck and head. Just let them hang. And we'll hang here in our forward fold position for a couple of breaths. Great. And from here, let's put our hands on the mat and walk our hands out into a downward dog position. So right now my feet are on the mat, about shoulders width apart. My hips are up towards the sky. My hands are also on the mat with my arms relatively straight, letting my head relax in between my elbows in downward dog position. I'm just gonna let push it back in. All right. And from our downward dog position, let's go onto our knees into tabletop position, and we'll take a couple of breaths here in cat and cow. So as we're in tabletop position, we'll take an inhale, As we inhale, we can arch our back and relax our head down. And then as we exhale into cow position, where our head is forward, have a slight sway in our back. Inhaling to cat, exhaling to cow. One more breath cycle. And from here, let's go into a lying position. So we're laying on our back. And I'm just going to elongate my body, making my body as long as I can as I lay on my back on the floor. Taking a couple breaths here. And we'll do one more cool down stretch by bringing our knees up above our core. I'm going to extend my arms out to the sides in a T shape. And then we'll do a lying twist by dropping our knees over to the right. So again, my arms are out in a T position and my knees are dropped over to the right side. And so we have a lying twist. I'm going to turn my gaze, my nose towards my left fingers to elongate that stretch through my neck. And on your next inhale, let's bring our knees up above our body by engaging our core. And as we have our core engaged, let's drop our knees over to the left side. Relaxing our knees on the floor, turning our nose towards our right fingertips. In a lying twist on the left side. And with that, it's hard to believe that it's the top of the hour already. I'm just going to come up in a sitting position and say thank you very much for joining us today for the circuit workout. Action packed.
Yeah, thank you, Megan. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, Megan.
You bet. Thank you have a good day, and we'll hope to see you back again soon.
I have a question for you before you log off, Megan.
Okay, sure. Let me stop the recording here. Whoops. That's not what I wanted to do. Hold on 1 second. All right.